some jellyfish have already been spotted in Narragansett Bay waters this year by early season boaters, ferry boat crewmen, and the occasional quahogger or two. Today's flashback is about some early spring season sightings of jellyfish, a more dangerous kind. This story is from 6 years ago today, April 30th, 2008.
These jellyfish were spotted right near the shores of Barrington Beach, where concerned beachcombers found some washed-up jellyfish.
Concern was from the person that called was, you know, children touching them, and indeed, while they're still wet, you can still get stung.
Their vibrant colors tempt a child to touch them.
And it ranges in colors from like yellows to dark purples and everywhere in between, and it looks like a lion's mane, that's hence the name.
Lion's mane are the largest known species of jellyfish. They catch the eyes of seasoned marine biologists every spring.
But that's nothing compared to the largest jellyfish that was spotted off the shores in Massachusetts. Its tentacles stretched the length of a six-story building that was spotted back in 1870.
Those tentacles sting, releasing a poisonous fluid. Lynch says if you have a bad reaction to a bee sting, then you'll most likely react badly to the sting of a jellyfish. In that case, it might be best to seek medical attention. But jellyfish aren't all bad. They keep the waters in check by feeding on live and dead prey. Leslie Urancian, NBC 10 News, Jamestown.
And that was 6 years ago today. Leslie Urancian worked for a short time as a reporter here in the latter part of that last decade. We understand she continues to work as a voiceover announcer, TV reporter, and occasionally in some recent movies. Maybe you know where she's based now?
I'm trying to get the dastardly computer to work. It's not working, but she does have a little baby now, so.
The computer doesn't work?
Wow. Oh, are we surprised, Frank?
Computers are supposed to make your life easier.
I can still try and get this while you tell us about something interesting coming up.
All right. At 4 minutes to six, something very interesting will return to the Rhode Island scene a little later this month. Water fire.
Yay.
It's 20th season. The first water fire lighting is Wednesday, May 14th, a partial lighting, with the first full lighting on Saturday night, May 24th. And the final lighting November the 8th. The schedule was announced yesterday by Barnaby Evans, a water fire creator, and some of the other people responsible for bringing us that wonderful event.
Summer's around the corner now. We can feel it now.
Do you know it was 20 years ago on New Year's Eve, 1994, the very first water fire.
Wow.
It's been on the scene for quite a long time.